All right, so with his reclassification, Marvin Bagley III becomes the top recruit in the 2017 class. And by adding the newcomer, Duke now has four of the top eight recruits in this year's class, according to ESPN 100. And Vegas certainly taking notice. The Blue Devils were co-favorites with Kentucky at 7-1 to win the upcoming national title prior to Bagley's announcement. But Duke is now a heavy favorite at 3-1, with Kentucky dropping to 8-1. So for the third time in the last four seasons, the number one player in the country has committed to Duke. For more on that, we bring in our basketball insider, Jeff Goodman. And Jeff, for those not completely familiar with the process, explain exactly how reclassification works for these kids in high school going to college.
Well, a lot of the kids that reclassify, Michael, are actually, they move back in the original class. Then they come back to this class, which is kind of what Bagley did. I mean, he turns 19 in March, so he's older if he had stayed in the senior high school class. Instead, he moves forward. According to my sources, he's taking three online classes right now. This has kind of been in the works for a while with he and his family, and specifically his dad, also named Marvin. This was the plan. They felt like he was ready for college, and certainly this speeds up the process in order for him to get to the NBA quicker.
Yeah, he will have to officially graduate later this month, and the NCAA will review his transcripts to confirm he's eligible to join Duke coming up here in the fall. But let's talk about Bagley, the player himself, Jeff. Measured at 6'10 and a half last summer, but can also create his own shot. With that being said, in terms of pro comparisons, what should fans expect for him when he's on the floor for the Dukies?
You know, I've been covering the recruiting game for 15 years, and I don't think there's anybody that is a great comparison to Marvin Bagley. One coach told me last night that Chris Bosh, coming out of high school, they were similar. And I remember Bosh a little bit. Obviously, he's got a thinner frame, but Bagley can step out, make some shots. He's powerful in the post. He's extremely versatile, agile. He can run the court. Another coach told me he plays hard, kind of like KG, and that's correct. I mean, that's something that really sets Marvin Bagley apart, how hard he plays as a big, and he can go in the post, do damage. Certainly, he's got to get better stepping away and making shots, and that's where he's not quite Chris Bosh yet, but this kid can do just about everything at his size.
You know, he's the number one recruit in this class now, would have been the number one recruit if he'd stayed back for the 2018 class, but it seems like in recent years we've heard more Jeff, from guys like Michael Porter Jr. or Zion Williamson or even Markelle Fultz, who came out last year. But in terms of overall talent, where does he rank among those guys that we probably watch on YouTube a bit more often?
You know, I think he's the most talented guy to come out of high school since Anthony Davis, and you know AD well, coming out of Kentucky. I give him a slight edge over Michael Porter Jr. I think both are potential franchise-changing guys at the next level, and I understand that neither have played a college game yet. Porter heading to Missouri this year and now Bagley going to Duke. But both versatile forwards, which is the way the NBA game has gone. So I think NBA guys who have yet to see Marvin Bagley in person will absolutely fall on it, watching him and his potential and even what he can do right away for Duke. Now, he'll be coming in late. Duke starts classes on August 28th, so he should be coming into Durham probably in the next week or so. So he'll be fighting from behind a little bit, but I expect him to fully catch up and be an impact player as long as he stays healthy.
Well, Jeff, you had a pretty interesting tweet last night where you said the winners from tonight, meaning after Bagley made his announcement, is one, Duke, clearly, two, college basketball, and three, bad NBA teams, in parentheses, and the Celtics. I think I know what you're talking about, but for the folks at home, what do you mean there?
Well, obviously, Duke is the big winner, and college basketball is a big winner, too, because they get a chance to see Marvin Bagley this year. But number three is anybody tanking or anybody that's going to be tanking are going to be bad. You know, Atlanta Hawks aren't going to be great. Sacramento is not going to be great. The Celtics have the Nets pick, which could be top five again and maybe the number one overall pick, depending on the ping pong balls. They also get the Lakers pick if it falls between 2 and 5. So think about this scenario. The Boston Celtics, who are maybe the third or fourth best team in the NBA right now and added Gordon Hayward and Jason Tatum, and then potentially could have the number one and two picks next year if everything falls just right. And that could mean, you know, a chance to get a Michael Porter and Marvin Bagley, or if you're Danny Ainge, do you move those picks and get an established player, maybe a superstar? I know, you know, fans here in Boston are thinking Anthony Davis, if everything goes completely astray down in New Orleans. I don't quite see that happening, but certainly Danny Ainge has plenty of chips to pull from right now.
So not only does the reclassification of Marvin Bagley III affect this upcoming college basketball season, but next year's NBA draft as well. With the very latest, that was insider Jeff Goodman joining us here on